A huge upset as 49th seed Karthikeyan Murali takes down top seed Maxime Vacher-Lagrave in round 10 of the Gibraltar Masters. A very happy Karthi joins us in our studio. Karthi, what a game, a huge win against Maxime. Tell us, how are you feeling right now?
Okay, I didn't prepare this opening at all. I was like preparing Bishop e2, Knight e5 for some like 1 hour, but I didn't consider h5 at all. During the game, I was like upset because I didn't see this line. But anyway, I managed to like at least get equal position because you were out of the opening and you don't know what to do there. After getting equal position, I think his mistake was Bishop g5. I think he unnecessarily wasted some moves there. Bishop g5, played Bishop g3 and Bishop h6, and I got Knight h4. So I think that was his huge mistake in the game. Other than that, I don't think any other mistakes he did there. Maybe instead of Bishop g5, I think maybe Rook g7 and Rook g8 was also there. There are so many ideas, but Bishop g4 was shocking for me. Yeah.
Right now, he in the night off went for this Knight g4, where Maxime does this often. He wants to see if White is okay repeating the moves and going for a draw. But you immediately played Bishop g5, yeah, wanting a game.
Yeah.
Was this your approach from the start?
Yeah, actually, I was preparing this at home because there's two options. Bishop e3, okay, I was preparing e5 also, but e5 didn't look like a winning attempt for black. So only winning attempt was Knight g4. So I can play Bishop c1, but I wanted to win today, to be honest. So that's why I played Bishop g5, I prepared it a lot. But honestly, I didn't prepare h5. So that was, I was very upset during the game about that. But anyway, somehow I managed to win from equal position.
You kept playing fast, so we couldn't really tell you were upset at all. Now, you say you wanted to win. Despite the massive rating gap between you and Maxime, yeah, that never played on your mind?
Okay, basically, he's also a human. It doesn't mean that, even if... Okay, he's Vacher-Lagrave, I accept that. But still, according to the tournament situation, I have to win the game to finish on the top. That's why I was considering to win the game today. I was fine with the draw, but from the opening, I think there was never a chance for repetition from the opening. So you had to play equal game from the opening itself.
That's super spirit. Now, Maxime is known for his super preparation.
Yeah.
But you today seem to out-prepare him. You were playing faster than him. You looked more confident. When you're in such a crucial stage of the tournament and you're playing someone like him, tell us the process of preparing for this round.
My main aim is not to get into some risky positions because, you know, being the tournament pressures and all, it might not suit the situation. So I was mainly planning to go to the positions where I have no risk. I can keep on trying till the end. But in today's game, I think there are more risk for me. But somehow I managed to, once I got rid of the queens, I felt that at least I'm equal there. So I was out of danger, but after Bishop g5, I felt I was better there. So my main approach was that I don't need to enter any risky lines, basically. That's why I played Bishop e3. But Knight g4 was like, Knight g4 was his winning attempt, I expected that. But by h5, I didn't analyze h5, to be honest.
You've had some very interesting games here, consistent play. Which, according to you, was your best game at the event?
According to me, I played with Mehmed Orhov, this Karokhan F6, the novelty. Okay, I prepared it long back, but it's not novelty, I don't know. But it looked like equal when I saw it in the home. So, that game I didn't make much mistakes. Only mistake was this F3, which I got Knight H6 and Knight F5. So, I felt that game I played really well.
Now, you started as the 49th seed. Mm-hmm. Today, you beat our top seed and you have a shot at the tie breaks. Mm-hmm. How are you feeling right now?
Okay, to be honest, I did my job. I don't really want to see others game because I want to concentrate on my game today. So, maximum I can win the game. So, I just did it and I'm waiting for the results of other games.
Now, we've had big Indian players come in here and participate, but you've been our star performer from the Indian representation ever. Feels good?
Yeah, of course. In such big tournament, to be like, at least I think second place is confirmed for me. So I'm very proud of this, yeah.
Also taking some big money back home.
Yeah, of course, yeah.
What are your plans?
Okay, I don't have much plans. I just have to go and play this Indian national team. So that's my next tournament, that's all.
Anything big that you've been wanting to spend the money on?
Okay, my main concern is to spend money on this foreign accommodation and flight tickets. So this money will be helpful for me.
And how important is such an event like Gibraltar in your career?
The events like this occurs only like twice or thrice. Let's say Gibraltar, Isle of Man. So to play this tournament, we need more cash. More funds. In my case, I didn't get the visa. It was in the neck of the time. I got visa like just 2 days before the event started. So these kind of tournaments will enhance our chess careers. So I'm looking for more tournaments like this.
And the experience to play with the big guys and beat them?
Yeah, of course. I just played good moves according to me. So even if they are, they are also 2700s, but if you play the best moves, even they should play the best moves according to the position. So I just keep on playing the best moves, and at some point they made some mistakes that gave me the win.
Now Vladislav's game is still going on.
Yeah.
Depending on the result, you may or may not play the tiebreak.
Yeah.
Are you thinking about that?
Okay, my main concern was to win the game today. I did that. So even if I had to play the tiebreaks, I don't mind. I just play it with my full energy. Yeah.
Super performance, Karthi.
Thank you.
Congratulations, and let's see what happens.
Yeah.
Well done.
Thank you very much. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.